And good evening, my fellow vapers, my fellow smokers, and hopefully my fellow future vapers. Thank you for joining us for another episode of The Smoker Show right here on YouTube.com/PBusaro. Good evening, Phil. How you doing? My brother, my fellow partner, my co-host.
I see how it is. Like, just pretend like you've been just perfectly nice to me leading right up to the show. Everything's fine. And now you come on and you're like nice to me in front of everybody so that everybody thinks that you're nice to me all the time. See, ladies and gentlemen, here's the deal, okay? Dimitri is not in a good mood.
Hold on a second. I'm not feeling well.
He's not feeling well.
But okay. When I perform, I put on my performance face.
And when he's not feeling well, it comes out as very mean and nasty to me. See, that's the thing. So we are actually considering something. And if we do this, it is going to be some funny, funny stuff. We are considering, and I'm going to let you in on something else later on. We are considering going to couples counseling.
Seriously.
And we're going to try to record the whole thing if we can.
By the way, yeah. I have to say this. Dan Donahue got the idea on us to couples counseling. But I do believe that we would benefit from couples counseling. I think it can't. I mean, it can't be no worse than it is right now.
I think so.
I mean, it really can't.
One of the things that is like, I'm a very, is it an emotional person? Is that what you want to call it? I'm an affectionate person. I'm an affectionate person. And, you know, every now and then.
You're what? An affectionate person?
I'm an affectionate person. You don't think I'm an affectionate person?
Sure you are. Sure, yeah.
Of course I am.
Sure.
And every now and then, like, I will go up to Dimitri and I'll just, like, put my arm around him and say, you know what? I really love you, man. You know?
How do you do that? Show me again. How do you do it?
I put my arm around you like this. And I love you, man. You know, like, I'll give you a little hug or something like that. You think I ever get that back from him? No. It's a very one-sided abusive relationship. I really don't get any emotion coming back towards me. No affection coming back towards me. Sad.
Oh my God. Well, look, the bad thing is that right now, if I did it at any given time after you've told me, it's going to look like it's fake. I'm doing it like you told me to do it.
Absolutely.
So, you know, there's really, you know, I just couldn't do it. So,
yeah. Can I share something here real
please,
quick?
Please.
This is going to be fast. It's only 15 seconds and I want to share this, and this is for Bill. And I think it's really important to show this. By the way, tonight is going to be a very, what's the word I'm looking for? Loose show, unprofessional show.
Isn't it loose every week?
All right, hold on. Let me just, I need to show this here. Let me just switch over to this screen. Let me just play this. Hold on. Watch this.
It's exciting.
Yeah. Look at that. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Right. Oh, wait, hold on. Okay. Now, I don't know if you noticed that, but none of them looked old. Like, none of them. They actually look quite attractive, mm-hmm. quite young, quite full of energy and life. You know, I mean, that's what Skechers brings to you, ladies and gentlemen. It brings comfort, and it brings excitement, and it brings life. It brings life, ladies and gentlemen.
The only way that they'd be able to sell Skechers to that demographic that commercial is showing is that if it came with a jewel. That's the only way they'd be able to sell to them. That's the only way those girls would ever be wearing Skechers. If it came with a 50 milligram mango pod for some head popping action. But seriously, I know. It's just unbelievable.
That's funny. Wow, you just hit my funny bone.
Did
I? Really, really did. Hey, we should thank our sponsors.
Absolutely, Miguel.
Like,
get back to that
page
ready for you. Go ahead, Phil.
All right, our sponsors. Of course, we have Inikin, who we work very, very close with on our platform products. We have Juno. We have MVS, aka My Vapor Store. We have Naked 100, Joytech, and Five Pawns. And last but not least, because I want to read a little something here, we have Lunar Rover, award-winning naturally extracted tobaccos, NETs, and premium cocktail flavors for adults who are ready to quit smoking. I hope
Fantastic.
You're ready for this.
Fantastic.
I hope you're watching this, and hope you're ready to quit smoking. Take one small step with Lunar Rover.
This...
And by the way, MVS, My Vapor Store, if you use the coupon code MTL10, That's going to give you 10% off your order. If you use the coupon code SMOKERSHOW with Lunar Rover, you're going to get 15% off your order. And I actually want to mention a Lunar Rover flavor because I said I was going to try it, and I did try it. I want to talk about it. I tried the bourbon peach, right? Uh-huh. But now I tried the strawberry mojito.
Yeah.
Have you tried the strawberry mojito?
Of course I have. I've tried all of Lunar Rover's flavor. Actually, I helped them when they were coming up with them. These flavors have been around for a while, yeah.
Here's what I like about this. Mm-hmm. Okay, here's what I like about this. For those of you who know a mojito is lime and mint leaves and sugar kind of muddled together. And then there's rum and there's seltzer on top of it.
It's just, hold on a second. I just want to put it out there. Like, you're really sounding like a mojito expert.
I kind of know a little bit about mojitos.
Wow. This one has, I'm impressed.
Yeah, I know you are. I know. but this one has strawberries muddled into it. But the cool thing about it is the mint.
Yes, the mint is really good.
Right? And here's why the mint is brilliant. Because it's not just mint. It tastes like a mint leaf.
Yeah, it does.
It really, truly, truly does. And I'm very impressed with the flavor, and I'm digging it. I'm truly
yes.
digging it.
And with good labels and no fancy marketing and nothing that would be harmful against the industry. Thanks to Redneck Pirate for his super chat. Love your show, guys. Keep going strong, y'all. When Phil decides on how we get that super chat, maybe we'll do something with that money and donate it to some kind of a cause. No, for a year, I haven't seen a penny out of it. I'll tell you that right now.
One day, I'll be 80 years old. I'll figure out how to do that. I'll take you out to dinner, Dimitri.
By the way, I have to say a huge thank you to your mom and dad for their hospitality at your house. And listen, folks, I can't make this stuff up. I mean, you know, Phil's mom and his dad have really embraced me like their own child. And I really appreciate that. And I see him as family to myself as well, too. But let me tell you how much of a family we get, okay?
I know what you're going to do. I know what you're going to say.
We get to the house Tuesday night, and we have to go to do the vape shop seminar for Good Guy Vapes, which we're going to talk about here in just a few minutes. But Phil says, do you have to iron a shirt tomorrow? And I said, yeah. So his mom says, I'm going to put the ironing board in the room next to you. I slept in Phil's brother's childhood bedroom. That's where I usually sleep when I go to the house. And in the bedroom next to me, which is an office now, she had set up the ironing board and the iron for me to iron. So Phil, of course, drops off 3 shirts, even though we're going to be in New Jersey for 2 days. He drops off 3 shirts at the room and says, can you iron them for me? And I said, sure. So I get up in the morning, and I'm ironing his shirts in my underwear in Phil's house. And, you know, it's just mom walking around. I mean, I just felt like I'm part of the house. You know, I mean, I just see her as a mother. I don't see, you know, I didn't have any problem.
You are totally part of that
you
family.
You cannot make this stuff up. But here's Phil's mom. She had made some just wonderful veal cutlets for us, you know, ready to have dinner. She had a quiche. She had some stuffed peppers, just classic Italian, you know, food. And his dad really, really busted my balls a lot. And I know where Phil gets it from. I mean, he's really cranky and he's really demanding and very opinionated. It's just exactly, it's a spit image of Phil Busardo. And his name is Phil Busardo as well, too. But his dad, like, I know exactly what to expect from Phil 10 years from now. Like, I've already seen the future, right? But it was great. We got to go see partially one of Phil's niece's softball game, Lexi. She was playing ball. It took us a while to get there because Phil's mom gave me the wrong address. That's a whole different story. But we got there, and we saw her play some ball. She had hits. She pitched really good. And it was just a great 2-3 days to spend up in New Jersey. And we got to have dinner with Dan at a fantastic restaurant.
Oh my God. Just amazing food. Really like that restaurant.
Yeah. Thank you.
Is Dan with us tonight?
I don't think so, but hopefully he'll see this on replay. But we were there for work, obviously. And what did we do, Phil?
We did shrimp. I got the pictures of the restaurant here. There's some of the food.
Oh God, it was just amazing. That was a Wagyu skirt steak right there. That's what Dan ordered.
This was the sea bass that you had.
Chili and sea bass, just absolutely to die for. Yeah,
really, really good. Where's the picture of my niece? I know it's in here somewhere. Why did you do that? Really? What?
That was terrible. Didn't do that. My wife did that.
Your wife is sometimes more brutal to me than you are at times.
I'm a great photographer. By the way, that's just a great picture, bro. That's a fantastic picture. Yeah.
That's my little niece, Lexi. I just love her to death. I wish I could spend more time with her. But yeah. All right. Anyway, we should probably get back to the show now.
Yeah, we should. Right. Yeah.
We did training. We did the Back to Basics seminar over at Good Guy Vapes. How many stores do they have, Dimitri?
I think they have 45 stores, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. And I'm going to go to some of these pictures here because we actually had to do this in two different seminars, two mm-hmm. different days, right?
Yeah.
So this is day one. And look at the number of people that are here at day one. And let me go through a couple more. They set up that because they do vape shows as well. Yeah. So they have like a huge LED panel that they piece together. And that's what they set up for us to do the slide presentation on, which was fantastic. Let's see. There's Dimitri presenting. Look at how good he is.
Oh, thank you.
But please, everybody, I want you to notice one part of this photo.
Oh,
here.
Jesus.
I'll point this out. His pants are way too short.
That's the style, bro. That's just the style. Get with it.
Listen, you know, I know you're trying to show off your non-Skechers shoes, but that's a little damn ridiculous. Really, buy yourself another pair of jeans. For Christ's sake, you're embarrassed.
I bought one today, by the way, for Germany.
This is the shirt. You know what? Let me go back to me here for a second. They did a really good job with this event. I mean, they really
my hat's off to them, for sure.
I think it was the best one that we've done by far. Okay. They took it very, very seriously. You could tell by the screen that they set up. They had breakfast and snacks for the people who came in early. Our seminar always winds up running long. We say 2 hours. We got to stop saying 2 hours. It's more like a 3-hour seminar. And they had it catered afterwards. And then they had everybody stay behind and do the photos. They really did it good. They really did a nice job with it.
Yeah.
So they had these T-shirts made that I survived the vape shop seminar featuring Phil Bisardo. Very important that they put my name first. I appreciate that.
Well, it's just because the B comes before V. But anyway, go ahead.
I don't think so. And Dimitri Agrafiotis there, aka Vape and Greek, and they got that right too. Vape and Greek, not vaping. Yeah.
Right, you know, on the money, man. Just top class.
They really did a good job. And we can see, let's see, I know they have Inikin on there somewhere too,
yep.
Because Inikin did sponsor the event. If I zoom in here a little bit, we can see there presented by Inikin. And then if I go to this next page or this next photo, we'll see this is day two.
Yeah.
Which was even bigger than day one. Yeah. That's a lot of people that we presented to.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right.
The owners of all the locations were there. Some of the franchisees were there. By the way, I'll put on the screen here. This is their website, and you'll see they just have tons of locations in New Jersey, New York, Maine, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, and South Carolina. But you can go on their website and just choose and see where their locations are. And they have like a little map on here as well too, which is really, really fantastic. But what I found really, really interesting was everybody, for the most part, was paying a lot of attention.
Yeah.
They were taking notes. They were being interactive. And that's why the seminar kind of goes a little bit long as well, too. It went 3 hours both days, but that's because there's interaction. And let me tell you something, folks. When you have interaction, you know that the people really care about the future of the industry. And when we do a seminar, we don't do a seminar to teach you how to vape. I think that's silly if you think that that's what our goal is. Our goal is to keep these moms and pops operations, the bloodline of this industry, which is the vape shop, in business, not today, but for the next, you know, decade or 20 years, if possible. And that's what the goal of the seminar is. And these people really need to appreciate the fact that they're probably working in one of their, you know, the best jobs they ever had. I mean, you get to vape, you're in a vape shop, you get to change lives and make money. I think that's a wonderful thing. So our goal is for them to go back to the basics, remember why they got into what they got into this in the first place, but also identifying the consumer in 2019 on how to cater to those consumers, how to convert not only smokers, but dual users, people that are using exclusively closed high nic pod systems. Maybe you want to convert them into an open system, different techniques, tips, But it's also a good opportunity for us to explain the thinking behind the products that we make, which are really designed for smokers. Yeah, I mean, sorry, we don't design for vapors. Listen, every reviewer out there designs for vapors. We try to design for real world people, people that have never tried vaping before. And that's what our goal is with the platform series of products through Inikin. So kudos to the guys at Good Guy Vapes, all their management team, all the owners. We got to visit Medusa Distribution on day two as well, too. We saw that facility in New Jersey. Very, very impressive distribution. We had really great talks about the future of the industry. We got some really good tips. This is the first time that we've talked to somebody and we actually got something back from it as well, too. And I think it was just overall a very, very successful trip.
Yeah, it was valuable. Jennifer Jarvis, hello and welcome. By the way, I was on Jennifer's show without
you. I know. I'm sorry.
Me and three other ladies, and there was no you. And I enjoyed every minute of it, by the way.
I bet you did.
If you were on the show, I wouldn't get to talk. I wouldn't get to say anything.
I bet you did.
To talk, and it was fun.
Well,
you know, we really do care. We care about the future of vape shops. You know, the vape shop is that place that you can go, and this is what we want it to be. We want it to be a comfortable place that anybody can go and get their questions answered, right, by somebody who understands vaping. And that's one of the main purposes of the seminar that we do. It's really important to have these shops continue to be around. You know, how many smokers really watch a P. Bisardo review? Probably not a lot.
Not many.
And maybe that's one of the reasons why I don't do as many reviews as I once did, because I'm more concerned about the smoker and reaching the smoker at this point. And, you know, what better place to reach a smoker than a vape shop? So it is so important for these shops to continue to be around. And the way they're going to continue to be around is continue to get new customers.
Absolutely.
And what does that mean? That means a conversion. That means a smoker doesn't smoke anymore. Now they vape. And you know, what a wonderful industry that we work in, where we make money by converting smokers to vapers to help them live a longer life. That's a pretty terrific industry to be involved with.
It really is. I'm very proud to do this next to you. I think that we do a really good job of bouncing of each other. We do have we tend to mix a little bit of ball busting in the seminar to keep it a little bit, you know, entertaining and keep the people engaged as well too. But I think that one thing that I really appreciate is when somebody that does have 45 stores, okay, and these owners are professionals. They're not some, you know, fly-by-night business people. Even them came up to us afterwards and said, even us, we learned a lot from this and we took notes and we're going to make adjustments and we're going to make change some things in the way that we operate our businesses for the longevity of this industry. And that made me feel really, really good. And I'm really proud to be doing that.
You know, and we usually hear that from a lot of the seminars that we've done. Sometimes we hear, you know, oh my God, thank you for saying the same things that you know, me, the owner, have been trying to ingrain into the employees' heads over and over and over again. Now, maybe if they hear it from you guys as well, they'll start to take it seriously. I personally think that's an issue. You should have control over your employees. Your employees should not have control over you as an owner, right? But they were excited. You know, even if they're implementing 90% of what we're talking about and we can give them 10% new information that they can use and utilize, I think we've done our job. I think that's a good thing. And, you know, they thought it was great. They got a lot of good information from it, and they are going to implement a lot of the things that we talked about. So kudos to Good Guy Vapes for taking the whole thing seriously and learning from it.
Yeah, fantastic. Let me just address a couple of things from the chat. Phil, want to let you know, my mom, 60 years old, absolutely loves the beep. So congratulations now to your mom. We really appreciate it. That's the kind of stories that we
love
hearing.
Thank you.
OG the Hemp Man, says, is it okay to use an RDA on a 70-watt mod? Absolutely. You can build an RDA to whatever resistance you want. You can use it on a 20-watt mod. You can use it on a 100-watt mod. It really doesn't make a difference. Absolutely. Rob Wiggles, are US-based shops just waiting until 2021 to see what happens, or you guys have a plan for worst-case scenario? I mean, we cannot let a date stop the conversion. In my opinion, this is what I tell all retail store owners, is that the more people that we convert into vaping, the better it's going to be when 2021 rolls around. You know, there's always the possibility of civil disobedience. If the FDA wants to go out there and shut down 10,000 vape shops overnight, I think it's going to be very hard to happen. It can happen, but that shouldn't deter you from trying to convert more people to discover vaping, in my opinion, in my humble opinion. And Holly Why, Archer, I am still a smoker and I watch. Well, welcome, Holly. We appreciate you being a smoker and watching, and hopefully you'll be able to discover vaping. If there's anything that we can do to make that possible for you, please feel free to let us know.
And you hang around, Holly, because we're going to have questions for you tonight, and we are going to get some product out to you tonight, okay? So, Holly, you are now on my mind.
On his mind. Of course, the telephone lines are open, 215-383-5752. I'm sorry that you had to see Phil Bisardo's legs on that shot. 215-383-5752. Press 1 when you hear the British lady speaking with any questions or comments. Tonight's show is going to be a little bit different.
I'm very white tonight. You notice how white I am? I'm very white. I got the white watch going. Very white.
You look like a vape virgin. By the way, today's going to be a little bit different. We are going to do a little bit of hardware. We haven't done this in a while, so we're going to do a presentation on a couple of products. I think it's always good letting you know, guys know what our thoughts on a couple of the new products that have come out that possibly could be used for conversions as well, too. And we are going to do a giveaway for the platform group that I have that I ran this morning. We're going to do that today so I can get in the mail tomorrow before we leave. We're going to be taking some calls and we're going to have some fun. That's pretty much what we're going to be doing today. And of course, the telephone lines are open for any of your questions or comments. I do want to bring up one thing. Where are we going this weekend, Phil?
Well, where we're going is to the airport again.
Again.
So actually, we're doing this. We're doing this, and then we're doing this, and then we're doing this. Yes. And then we're doing this. Okay. So what we're doing is we are going to be flying out tomorrow, actually. I fly in the afternoon. Dimitri flies very, very early to Philadelphia. We're going to meet up in Philadelphia, where we will fly to Madrid, Spain. Because believe it or not, it was less expensive to fly to Madrid, Spain, and then from there to Germany than it was to fly directly to Germany. How about that?
Yeah.
We're flying to Madrid. From Madrid, we're going to Germany to attend the Hall of Vape there. Very, very excited about that. Ira and Dirk and the team are doing an outstanding job setting things up and getting ready for the first ever Smoker Show Live that we are going to be doing in at the Hall of Vape. Now, that might sound like we're just doing the show live from the Hall of Vape. That's not really what it is, okay? So what we are going to be doing is we're going to have a booth, and the booth is going to be right at the front of the event. Let me
put that up there so everybody can see. Yep, this is the entrance of the Hall of Vape, and you see that the first booth that you're going to find on the left is the Smoker Show booth, which, of course, once again, has been filled and stocked with a bunch of product from our sponsors. Yeah.
Yeah. All of our sponsors did kick in with product and with e-liquid, and I can't thank our sponsors enough. We do have signage for our sponsors at the event. But what Ira and his team did was they handed out, which I think is a brilliant idea. They handed out cigarette lighters, okay, to smokers, and they told them that if you look at the back of the cigarette lighter, it's a free ticket. It's a free ticket to get into the event, and you can trade that lighter in at the Smoker Show booth, where they will receive some really quick consultation, because it's going to be tough to spend a whole lot of time with everybody who's coming in. Some quick consultation. They will receive a device. They will receive liquid to get them started. And then if they want, they can take one of the people who are going to help with the booth, one of the volunteers who will just kind of walk them around the show and introduce them to, what is vaping? Because as you can imagine, a smoker walking into a show like that is going to be extremely overwhelmed, right? Very, very overwhelmed, and may not even like what they see. So I think it's really important what we're doing, how we're doing it. The goal here is to get the smokers back into these shows. And I really hope that other shows see this, they take it to heart, and maybe they invite us to do the same thing at their show as well.
You know, they've already invited us to do it at other shows as well, too. But we promised Ira he would be the first one. This will be the test market. Our goal is to convert 70 German smokers. Hopefully, it'll be 170. But that's our goal. That's our goal number to hit, is 70 smokers in Germany to convert them over to vaping. But I think the most important part of this is the follow-up. We want to follow up with them. We want to get their email address and send them out a little questionnaire and ask them a week later, what's going on? How is it working out for you? What are you getting out of it? What are you missing? What are you having issues with? That feedback, I think, is more important than just passing out a device and a liquid. If we don't know what happens, and I'm not trying to downplay what's happening and if you do this somewhere else. I'm not. All I'm trying to tell you is that one of the biggest issues, by the way, why isn't your name coming up? Why isn't your name out there?
I don't know. Well, why is it? Look,
I don't know what happened to your name.
They know who I am. It's okay.
Yeah, I know. I just now noticed it. But why isn't it showing up? Let me see.
Believe it or not, no. Holly, this is not a Chroma. Typically, this would be a Chroma, but this is one of the devices that we're going to talk about tonight.
Great. So. Thanks for interrupting me. But anyway, so because I do have the
questions. You interrupted you because my name isn't there.
I have
anymore.
The questions there that come in from the chat, by the way. Just put you out there because if you just reply without reading out the question, nobody knows what you're talking about. So anyway, so as so I was saying.
This is why we need counsel.
Not to take away from anything that's happening in other shows. But I think one of the biggest problems that we have is we don't know what happens to that person when they leave. They don't have the support, right? We don't know if it worked for them, if it leaked, if it burned out the next day, if they got a dry hit and they threw it away. And I think that's the most important part of any person that's converting. That's the feedback that we get, especially in the first couple of weeks. And that's what we're going to try to do at the Hall of Vape. And we do certainly appreciate the team, Ira and his team, for making this possible. And we're very, very excited to do that. So that's going to happen at the Hall of Vape on the two consumer days, B2B. We're going to be obviously at the Innokin booth showing off our new products. And I think we're going to do a small presentation of the vape shop seminar as well, too. Just like an abbreviated version of it. And yeah, and then B2C, we're going to be hanging around at the Smoker Show booth and trying to help people quit smoking. Then what are we going for?
Believe it or not, I'm not even sure the name of the event.
So first of all, we're leaving. We're doing three countries in 9 days. Okay, just put that. Three countries in 9 days. So we're going to Germany, Stuttgart, Germany. After the Hall of Vape, we are flying to Lisbon in Portugal, and we're spending 2 days with a Vaporize Art team.
Doing that? Is that what we're doing? Because the last I knew, we were just flying to Madrid.
Don't worry about it. Just follow me. I'm going to get you one of those harnesses that they have for babies at the airports, and I'm just going to harness you up and just pull you around. Just follow me, and we'll get there.
We talked about that, too. That would make a good video. Go ahead. All right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
For 2 days, we're going I'm trying. For 2 days, we're going to Lisbon, Portugal, to visit some vape shops with the Portuguese team. And of course, after that, we're going to the VAP Expo in Madrid, Spain, which is going to be June 8th and 9th. So we'll be in Madrid, Spain for that show, of course, at the Vaporize booth, representing Innokin and showing our products there. So if you're anywhere in that vicinity of these three countries in the next 9 days, please come out. Give us a hug. We would love to meet you and have a wonderful vape together.
Yeah. And bring a Red Bull with you because we're going to be exhausted.
I know. And it doesn't stop there. I wish it did. But anyway, so that's what we have going on for the next 10 days. Just keep an eye out on our social media, whether it's going to be YouTube or Facebook Live. We're going to do videos from the Hall of Vape, from the Smoker Show booth, kind of see the interaction that we're having with the German smokers. And hopefully, you know, that will trigger some urgency to our industry to look after the smoker and not just the vapors anymore. I'm going to tell you what I'm doing. You want me to tell you what I'm doing, Phil?
You're doing a big giveaway, aren't
you? I'm doing a lot of stuff. You know why? The 31st of May, guess what day it is, Phil?
It's National Smokeout Day.
It's the World Health Organization Anti-Tobacco Day. Right, which is the worst organization in the world, the World Health Organization, which cares absolutely nothing about your health. I am going to ride on their back. I'm going to ride on their back. And I started this in Greece. I know this is in Greek, but I will translate for you. I partnered up with some other partner vape shops that I have there in Greece that I work with. My shops, of course, are the Liquid Puff shops, the Vape Port, Vapor Mania, which me and you visited, by the way, and Vape Avenue all have joined forces on the 31st of May. If you come into the stores with an IQOS or a pack of cigarettes, we will give you an EQ and a 10-mil bottle of tobacco liquid and help you make the switch to vaping. Just kind of let you, you know, try something new and see if vaping is going to work for you with no money whatsoever. So this is what we're doing in Greece, and hopefully other people. And I'm not saying that because I'm better than you. I am trying to motivate you, the stores, the business owners, the manufacturers, the distributors, the liquid makers, the DIYers. I'm trying to motivate you to take advantage of this day and ride on the back of this world corrupt health organization and show to people that we can help people convert and we can help people quit smoking. So whatever you do, if it's just a friend that you want to give away one of your older kits, if you're a liquid guy, you want to give away some free liquid, if you're a hardware guy, you want to give away some devices or a vape shop or anything, get out there the 31st of May, take some pictures, post it on your social media. Let's hashtag this World Anti-Tobacco Day and utilize it for our advantage as well too as vapers, because I think this is a day that we can make a huge change. And of course, on my personal social media, because I'm just a very, very nice guy, on my Instagram, this is the post picture that I posted today. And I have 7 starter kits there, including a direct lung kit, because people say, well, direct lung helps me quit smoking as well, too. So to keep those guys happy, I have 1 direct lung kit. I have an EQS, an EQ, the new Gala, a beep, a beautiful pink a beep, a beautiful pink cool fire kit, and a beautiful purple chroma kit. 7 starter kits. 7 starter kits on my Instagram, which I am hoping that vapers will win, right? It's going to be 7 different winners. They'll win this, and when they get this kit in their hands, they can pay it forward to a friend, to a family member. Now, listen, if you're just going to get this giveaway just to have another one, I don't care. I can't control that. I really can't. All I can do is what I can do, my small part to help. From there on, if you want to take the Gala and, you know, shove it up your ear, that's your own business. I'm not telling you what to do with it. I am hoping that you would find it into your heart to get one of these kits if you're an advanced vapor and pass it on to a friend that smokes, and maybe you can change your life and feel good about yourself. That looks really sexy with a Gala in your
head. Doesn't work, though. It doesn't.
You're doing it wrong. You need to put the other side in.
Oh, sorry.
I'm just kidding. All right. So now I am done. I did. I reposted that. You know, somebody heat treated a slide. Did you see that? You saw it. That was a few weeks ago. Well, they heat treated the top cap and the bottom cap of the slide. It looked really good.
That was pretty cool.
Anyway, let me see. Make sure I got everything that I wanted to say. That was a lot.
The IQOS definitely coming here to the United States, and to me, it's just it's a glorified cigarette. Definitely has it's tobacco harm reduction. Without a doubt, it's tobacco harm reduction. But I'm very curious. If vaping is at least 95% safer than smoking, I'm very curious what that number is when it comes to an IQOS. Extremely.
I don't, to be honest with you, I don't have anything against the IQOS. Right, all no. I'm saying is if you want to get rid of tobacco because this is an anti-tobacco day, the IQOS has tobacco. Guess what does not have tobacco?
Vaping.
Vaping doesn't have tobacco. So you see what I'm doing? Get it?
Sure.
Get it?
It's world. It makes sense.
It's not anti-nicotine day. It's anti-tobacco day.
That's right. If it was anti-nicotine day, then we wouldn't be able to give anything away, right? But this is anti-tobacco day. And an IQOS, for those of you who don't know, that is a heat not burn product. It uses a little, what do they call them? Heat sticks?
That's exactly what they call them.
It's a cigarette. I mean, it's a little cigarette, right? Yeah. With loaded up with tobacco and some other chemicals that you find in traditional tobacco cigarettes. And there's 2 prongs, or these prongs that go into it. They heat up and they release tobacco flavored nicotine vapor, right? But it's still tobacco.
Still tobacco. Still has tar. I've seen the application. We've seen what it has in it. It's still safer than cigarettes. There's no doubt about it, because you're heating and you're not combusting.
Hold on a second. You need to fix this, because Single Stack just asked, who's the guy on the right with no name?
Oh, my God. See, I'll have to fix that. Okay. Can you just talk while I'm fixing it?
Can you?
By the way, if you didn't know who he was, here you go. Everybody can see it. There you can go while I'm fixing it, okay?
Let me fix it now. Phil Bissardo.
You see that? What it says there? What does it say there? Yeah,
it says Phil Bissardo, www.tasteyourjuice.com. That's my website. Are they serious? Ginger Girl is here. Hello, Ginger Girl. Holly, you hang out, because we're going to take care of you, Holly. We got to ask Holly some questions tonight. Does that person really not know who I am, or are they busting balls?
They could be busting your balls.
Single Stack is LOLing. So, yeah. Did you get it fixed yet, Dimitri?
I'm trying to fix it. Just give me a second. It just takes a while. Why is your color up?
This is a very simple problem let's see. I'll read some of these questions here.
Yeah.
I'm curious, Phil, how's the flavor difference between smoking a cigarette and IQOS? You know what, Flavor Pro Jennifer Jarvis, that's one of the things that IQOS is going to have over us in vaping. It tastes like a cigarette. I mean, it tastes like a cigarette. right? Which means it tastes like shit. You know, we all smoked, or a lot of us smoked in the past, and you know, we loved the taste of our cigarettes. But I think when we become vapors and we start to, you know, maybe you start off with a tobacco flavor, and then you move into the other gazillion flavors that you can enjoy as a vapor. The taste of a traditional tobacco cigarette definitely is something that is not desirable anymore. To me, it's not a desirable flavor. It's not a desirable taste anymore. But you know, for a smoker looking to get their nicotine in a less harmful way, thank you very much. You know, that flavor may be very, very desirable, and that is definitely something that IQOS is going to have over vaping for sure.
I want to change my color now too, because your color looks better. I made yours a little bit more blue.
Let me make mine a little bit more blue.
Okay, there we go. I fixed it now, babe. So anyway, do either of you speak German? Absolutely not. I can't even pronounce Snitchel. So this. But let me tell you something, Dirk and the team there, we have volunteers. We have YouTube reviewers from Germany. They're going to participate. We're going to have a bunch of people there that speak German at the booth to make sure that we can get translated to the people that don't speak English. So, yeah, we're not concerned about that. How serious is popcorn lung? Not one case reported due to electronic cigarettes, so we can't really tell you. But there is really no popcorn lung cases to be reported. That's kind of been exaggerated for the people that don't know. There's only been one case of popcorn lung reported, and that was from a factory worker that worked actually at a popcorn factory that sprayed butter onto the popcorn. And he worked there for years, and his lungs got exposed to that buttery mist that he kept inhaling. Don't overthink some of these media stories, which is going to be my next segment. That's a good segue.
Keep in mind how that person got popcorn lung. They are working in a popcorn factory.
Correct.
They are around that buttery flavor floating around in the air. They have their head over vats of the stuff. And it took how many years before that one case?
A lot of years, yeah.
Okay. So I wouldn't be all that concerned with popcorn lung when it comes to vaping. Now, but that's not the case with some people. So if you are concerned, the question that you're going to ask from the manufacturer of your favorite e-liquid, you're going to ask them, does it contain DI and AP, diacetyl and acetylpropylene? And I think there's a couple more. Maybe Jennifer can remind me here in the chat. But there are questions that you can ask, and that e-liquid company, that manufacturer, really needs to be forthcoming with giving you good information.
Absolutely. By the way, people are saying that his tan looks very good, and I look a little ghostly.
My tan is so good right now. I wish that I could show you my tan lines. They would be breathtaking. Everybody would be like, oh my God, look at your tan lines. But I can't do that on the show.
So just to let you know, PSS, this month, meaning this month of April, I have been home for 8 days. And in between my 7 trips that I had, which is a total of 14 flights and I think a couple of connectors, I think made it 16 flights this month. So in the 8 days that I actually did spend at home, I wrote 2 op-eds and formed a political action committee here in Tennessee. So, yeah, I might look a little bit ghostly, but I don't have time to sit on the dock like Phil does or get in my boat and go for a ride and go fishing. And I do apologize for that. When my time comes to take a vacation in July, I hope to get a tan just like Phil Busardo. And I'm not trying to be bitchy, but I am being bitchy because this has been a rough month for me. It has been really, really rough. And on top of that, I feel like crap today.
He does.
Here doing the show. No, I'm just kidding, PSS. He does look great. He does look robust and creamy and Italian, whatever. Okay.
He does.
You happy?
If it'll make you feel any better, I finally actually got a chance to take the boat out. We were going to go fishing yesterday. We put all of our fishing gear in the boat. We put the coolers in the boat. We took the boat out. You know, what would you say? It's about like a 20-minute drive to the point where we could speed up, right?
Do you actually drive a boat or do you like sail a boat? Because you said 20-minute drive.
You sail a sailboat. You drive a motorboat. Okay?
You drive a boat?
Yeah, you drive a boat. You don't sail.
Is that
a boat.
What they said?
Okay. Can I get to the final part of the story?
Yeah, go ahead.
We take it out and I go ahead and gun it. And I instantly drop a cylinder. I lost a cylinder. Aww. I have no idea why. I know. All I know is it's brand new. And I'm kind of cranky about it. And I'm pissed off because I had that one day to go out there and enjoy it. And, yeah, you know, there's, I guess, there's worse problems to have. But
you pilot a boat. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Steven. I was right. I might be Greek, but my English was right on that one, so I don't want to hear it. So, speaking about pissing off and my ghostly look, this is going to really piss you off.
Who, me?
E-cigarettes are an epidemic among youth today, experts say. But adult smokers hope vaping can help them quit cigarettes and lower their increased risk for heart disease. The problem? Research suggests vaping may also pose a risk.
We're seeing more and more evidence that e-cigarettes do have a relationship with increased chance of having a heart attack.
Nicotine raises your heart rate and blood pressure, constricts blood vessels, and interferes with platelets that clot your blood.
And with that, the risk of heart disease can increase.
Traditional nicotine replacements lower the amount of nicotine until the person is no longer addicted. But in e-cigarettes,
what we're finding is that there's a wide variation in the amount of nicotine that people are exposed to. We don't know the long-term risk of e-cigarettes.
So along with this story that's been running rampant today, you'll notice that CNN, your favorite website, Phil, is reporting also that e-cigarette flavors can damage the cells that line your blood vessels and perhaps your heart health down the line, according to this new study that was published on human cell labs in the lab. This was done, this study was funded, by the way, by the American Heart Association, of course. And I do want to bring something up. That these are the type of stories that really deter adults from trying vaping, right? When you hear stories like, we don't know the long-term effects of vaping, is like saying, I am on a ship right now. Speaking of piloting the boat, right? I'm on a boat that's sinking. Obviously, probably the one that Phil is piloting. I'm on a boat and it's sinking, right? And on the boat, there's a raft. And there is a possibility in that raft that there's a hole. There is a possibility. We don't know because we don't know. We've never used this raft before. So what you're telling me is I should not use this raft because there is a possibility there's a hole on it and I got to stay on the ship that is sinking. That's exactly what people are suggesting that you do, right? We don't know the long-term effects of vaping, but we do know the long-term effects of smoking. And it's going to kill you, all right? 1 out of 2 customers die from smoking. We know that for a fact. And that's what really, really aggravates me is when they use that term. What they're trying to say is that, yeah, they might be safer, but we don't know what's going to happen in 30 years. Well, guess what, folks? I know what's going to happen in 30 years, in some cases shorter than 30 years, like my father did, dying at 40 years old, from the effects of smoking on your body and on your heart. In this particular case, Dr. F. thankfully has put out a response, which I want to bring up now. I won't go over it too detailed, but in this particular study about the flavors, keep in mind, let me just move to this camera. Keep in mind, in this study here, they used only 2 vapors. This is a study that they spent millions on, right? They spent millions on this study. This was a grant, right? They used 2 vapors, 5 people in total in the study. 2 of them were vapors, two vapors, and they came out with this conclusion. And they did not use vapor on the cells. They actually exposed cells to the liquid, which is not how we use it. We don't take our liquid and drink it or expose it directly onto the cells of the heart. We actually vaporize it. So the study right off the bat is completely null and void. It's completely fraudulent, okay? You cannot expose anything that you're going to expose a healthy cell to, especially chemicals, because there are chemicals in vape e-liquid, is going to change the composition of the cells, period. If you expose a healthy cell to Phil Bussardo's gas from his farts, it's going to alter that cell, okay? So it really, really pisses me off that this study was taken seriously and spread through wildfire through CNN and all the affiliates of Associated Press. It's just what PR firms do. And it really pisses me off that people are taking this at face value and actually posting it to my wall like, oh, you see vaping, what it does? But anyway, I will post the link inside the replay description as well, too, for the people that want to read the exactly thing. But the new study that was published in the Journal of American College of Cardiology identified that e-cigarette flavors, particularly cinnamon, can be toxic to the heart by having oxidative and pro-inflammatory properties. Researchers used human-induced pluripotent stem cells, derived cells, which were exposed to 6 commercially available e-cigarette liquids, which were not vaped. Okay, he makes that in bold. They were not vape. Let me make this a little bit bigger so you can see that. They were not vape. They were just used in liquid form, which is not how the product is used. Why would this study was even published is beyond me. They identified increased cytotoxicity, stress, and inflammatory response, particularly with the cinnamon flavor. Another part of the study examined the acute effects of using e-cigarette or tobacco cigarette by collecting serum from 5 smokers and 4 e-cigarette users, 2 of them who were dual users. So they took it from 5 people, right? 4 e-cigarette users. Now the e-cigarette users, 2 were dual users. So we don't even know if it was vaping or smoking that caused this. Actually, only 2 were full-time electronic cigarette users. And they were measuring several markers of inflammation and response of these cells in vitro. This part of the study is of limited value since it's irrelevant to flavoring effects and included very few participants. I wonder, however, how hard it is to find exclusive e-cigarette users in the U.S. so they can avoid combining exclusive and dual users into the group. I want you to read the whole thing because, in short, what it says here is that, listen, vaping does have some chemicals, and if you're going to pour chemicals on any kind of cell, you are going to get a change in the cytotoxicity. That's just common sense. If you're a smoker reading this story, you're probably going to get concerned about vaping. But let me tell you something. Nobody in this industry, and if they do, please point them out to me because I will call them out by name. Nobody in this industry is telling you that vaping is safe. Nobody. Nobody. Guess who else is not doing it? Us that are doing this show. What do we always say on the show, Phil? Let me just bring it up here one more time. Let's do it one more time.
I think that slide is really important, okay? Because although most studies conclude that vaping is far safer than smoking, we strongly recommend that if you do neither, you continue to do neither. Smoking equals bad. It's bad for you. We know this. Reducing cigarettes through vaping, good. Not perfect, but good, okay? Eliminating cigarettes through vaping, that's better. That is where you guys want to be. That is true tobacco harm reduction. Get those cigarettes out of your life. Not smoking and not vaping, it's right there in the slide. That's the best. Okay? And we just saw it. We just saw those 2 negative articles. And what do we say about negative articles? If you see a negative article about vaping, question whether or not that article compared the negative to that of a traditional combustible tobacco cigarette. If it does not, in our opinion, it is invalid. Vaping is harm elimination, not harm. Vaping is not harm elimination. I did that once before too. Vaping is not harm elimination. It's not eliminating harm, but it is definitely, without a doubt, harm reduction. And once again, Dimitri, we see another study that just points out all these bad things. And there was another negative thing about that study that really made me mad. Okay. But they don't compare. They don't compare to this bad thing that they found with vaping to Absolutely. That of a cigarette. Absolutely. Because if they did, if they just made a simple fucking chart with 2 little bars, okay? I like charts.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
Put 2 bars together and you're gonna see vaping here and you're gonna see smoking here. That's what you're gonna see. But they don't wanna show you that. They don't wanna tell you that. All right. And the other thing that really made me mad is they said, well, traditional cessation products allow you to start to reduce your nicotine. Well, guess what? You can do that with vaping and you can't do that with a Juul.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I definitely agree with you. And by the way, if you do want to see the effects of tobacco versus smoking on heart cells. Let me pause this real quick. If you do want to see the effects of vaping on heart cells, go on YouTube and look at this video that I actually posted January 31st, 2013. God, that feels like 100 years ago. This was the episode where we had Dr. Fasalinos on, and we've actually cut the clip out. It's 27 minutes long. Just search for it on YouTube, and you're going to see actual studies of smoke hitting healthy cells and e-cig vapor hitting healthy cells. And this is what we wanted with this study as well, too. If you're going to hit it with liquid, squirt liquid on it. Why don't you just hit it with a cigarette as well, too, and see what happens to that cell? Guys, I'm telling you, and I've seen this with my own 2 eyes in a lab. The difference is by magnitudes just more devastating when smoke hits it versus when vapor hits it. And this is the way that we use our products. We don't squirt liquid on our heart cells. We vaporize it. And when you're vaporizing it, it's being absorbed completely different. Go out there and see that video. We had this video on since 2013. And instead of vapors taking this video and posting it We're just spreading around this horrible, horrible CNN news story that got picked up by AP and by various other organizations. And it really, really pisses me off. Not once will you ever hear us tell you that vaping is safe. But what we can tell you with the available data right now in the science, that it's much safer than traditional smoking. And this is all we are here to do. We're reducing the harm that is being caused by the nicotine delivery method that you're using now and not the nicotine itself.
Right. And just keep in mind, folks, don't go crazy looking for all this stuff at this point right now. There's always a replay of this show on my website, tasteyourjuice.com. And if we mention anything like we're mentioning here, we're mentioning the response from Dr. Farsalinos, we're mentioning the video that Dimitri just talked about, links to all that stuff is always put up with the replay on the tasteyourjuice.com website.
You know, 2013, it's just crazy because we were just talking about the other day. You got a couple of reviewers going to China showing factories. You know, we did that back in 2014, folks. You know, effects on the sale, we did that back in 20. A lot of the new vapors forget how long that me and Phil have been around. We're pretty much dinosaurs. That's why we really need to go to counseling. So once again, thanks to Dan Donahue for suggesting that. I don't know how it came across his lap that we go for counseling. Maybe he's going to counseling too. Who knows? Maybe it's working out for him. But let me answer some questions. Yeah. So yeah, that study is being, you know, spread around like wildfire today. When you reply, make sure you reply with accurate information. Dr. F has it up on ecigaretteresearch.org. YouTube, Vape Team Media has a response on that as well too, back from 2013. And always be prepared to answer the question correct. We are promoting a safer delivery method of nicotine, a reduced harm level, the way that you can intake your nicotine. We never suggest that this is completely safe and completely harmless because exactly we don't know. We're not scientists. We know what the available data is right now that it's less harmful as it is.
Hey,
right
before
now.
You take questions, why don't you go ahead and take care of one of our sponsors with a brief commercial.
I'm not prepared to do that yet, but excuse me a second. Give me a second. I'm not prepared to do that. But anyway, yeah, let me just take a question. Maybe you'll be able to answer it. So I'm going to bring this up to you because I know how you love answering this. So Phil, what are your thoughts of nicotine salt versus regular e-liquid?
Okay. Personally, I don't like nicotine salt. Okay. Mm-hmm. For me, it doesn't simulate smoking enough, right? I personally like, you know, and everybody's gonna vape for a different or they're gonna enjoy vaping in different ways. Everybody's gonna like different flavors. Everything is subjective when it comes to vaping. So for me, it doesn't work. Okay, I don't get that throat hit thump. That sharp, I always talk about this in my videos, I don't get that sharp, defined throat hit thump that I also enjoy and also need from my vaping. That is something that I get from a standard nicotine, a 12 milligram in a mouth to lung style tank. That is my style of vaping. That is what I enjoy. There's absolutely no need. And if you find a style that you like, if you find something that you like and you're not smoking, you know, I guess you can try other things, but don't go out and look for the greatest, the latest and the greatest. Don't go out looking for the hype stuff. Stick with what works for you, right? Whether that be a freebase or a standard nicotine or a salt nicotine. I personally just don't like the sensation that I get from salts. I don't like the feeling that I get from salts. but the idea behind a salt nicotine is to allow you to uptake or go to a higher nicotine value, a higher milligram, okay, but be able to vape it. Because if you were to vape, we'll say a 50 milligram, which is what you're going to find in a Juul, if you were to vape that in a standard or a free-based nicotine, it's going to be extremely harsh. So they treat the nicotine with benzoic acid and whatever the hell else they do with it to kind of soften the blow. It smooths it out. So that you're able to take that high of a nicotine a value or concentration and be able to vape it, right?
Yeah, 50 milligram nicotine salt versus 50 milligram regular, they're both 50 milligram. You're not changing the content of nicotine. The addition of acids, all it does is just smooth down the hit. And I'm not a fan of smoothing down the hit because I think that if the hit is too smooth and the nicotine is too high, then you have initiation. It's something that we're seeing kids picking up the Juul. And I just think that the term smooth is a deceiving ploy by Big Tobacco. I'm sorry. That's just the way that I feel. You might disagree with it if you're a vapor, but it does reminisce me of Camel Smooth. Remember that? You remember that big campaign that they did with Joe Camel back in the day? I think that there should be a balance between the harshness to cut down the initiation and the nicotine content to satisfy an adult smoker. I don't like this extreme. I really don't like the extreme that you're actually intaking 50 milligrams. It's no effect on your throat at all. It causes over-nicking. I think it causes initiation. I think you cannot control the nicotine and titrate your body in the way that we can with regular nicotine. So I am personally, I'm against those very, very high nic strengths with a smoothness.
Do I need to do my rant again? Should I do my rant one more time?
I don't think you should rant. I think we're having a really, really good time. But I think that people need to realize that we're not against the product. I think that there is a place in the market for it for those that smoke heavily, that regular nicotine might not be able to satisfy them. I just think that the sales should be controlled a little bit tighter, especially in those high content nicotine.
You know what? I'm gonna rant anyway. Screw you. Because it just twists my nuts every time I hear it. I see a couple of people asking questions about the four milliliter pod for the or tank for the ZB. It's coming, guys. It's got to be perfect. It's not perfect yet, but we are aiming for June. This is actually a prototype right here. I think you guys are gonna love it when it does come out. I love this one, but June is when they should be for sale on the 4 milligram or the 4 milliliter. Here's the thing that really twists my nuts. Okay. Here's what twists my, besides Dimitri, here's something else that really twists my nuts. Somebody tries vaping and they try a Freebase. Okay. And they try a 12 or an 18. They go, it makes me cough. And they put it away. They don't want to use it because it makes them cough. Okay. Every person that I know who have stuck with a 12 or an 18 no longer coughs. And here's the thing that really bugs me. Here's the thing that really, really bugs me. Because when you took one of these out, this is my stunt pack, by the way. When you took one of these or another brand, when you took it out of the box for the very first time and you put it in your mouth and you lit up, okay, what did you do on your first inhale? Did you go, oh my God, that is so smooth and wonderful? No, you coughed. You coughed. You coughed and you hacked, okay? And then what did you do? You took another drag. And what did you do after that? You had another cigarette. And then what happened? You didn't cough anymore, and now you're a smoker, okay? So, and this is what aggravates me when people say, it made me cough, okay? Do me a favor and give the at least 95% safer alternative to this just as many options, just as much opportunity and chances as you gave this. That's what bugs me. That's what really, really bugs me. Is that when somebody makes me cough, okay? So did that first cigarette. So did that first cigarette. But you worked through it. You dealt with it. You dealt with that. That made you a smoker, okay? Do the same with vaping. Increase your VG a little bit. Bring your power down a little bit. Bring your nicotine down a little bit. Suck a little different.
Mm-hmm. That plays a big role. Whatever.
There's a lot of different things that you can do to adjust and get used to it. You won't cough anymore. You won't hack anymore.
Take a deep breath.
That is something that it just makes me mad. It makes me mad, makes and me I will continue. Too.
I think
that
it's a cop out
until the day I die.
Yeah, okay? I agree with you. Take a deep breath now. We're going to take a quick break.
By the way, are you prepared now? Are you prepared for the
my wife smoked Marlboro Ultralight 100s, by the way. So it's ironic when you brought that up, I had a little flashback. But back from Joytech, an oldie from the past, redone the E-Roll. The E-Roll Mac is back. So here's a little quick video about it. We'll be right back. You know what I find really funny about these? Everybody was making fun of me and Phil last year because we were still vaping at 1 ohm, 1.2 ohm resistance. We were dinosaurs. We were vaping 12 milligram. And all of a sudden now, everything is going to 1.5 and 2 ohm resistance with 50 milligram nicotine. Kiss my Greek ass. Where were you last year? Where were you last year when we were trying to promote tobacco harm reduction? Get out of here, you jokers. But anyway.
Everything's mouth to, or a lot of stuff is mouth to lung now, too.
I am welcoming back this E-roll for a couple reasons. I love the PCC case, and I think that's something that's very, very much needed. And I also love the fact that it's round. I think we need more round, small devices for people to be more, you know, relatable to a cigarette versus some of the, like I'm going to show you folks where my travel piece is going to be tomorrow, right? I usually carry a small pod system. I usually use the EQ, obviously, because I really like the fact that I can use salt nicotine or regular nicotine in. Tomorrow during my flight, I'm going to be using the limited edition.
Oh, really?
This is what I'm going to be using tomorrow. Let me get the close-up cam here. I'm going to be using the Phil Busardo is deep-throating a banana EQ edition of the EQ. Look at that. Such form in your mouth. And I'm going to be looking at it every time I'm going to be taking a vape. It's so sexy. It's just so very sexy. Look at that. It's just so sexy. So I'm going to be using that. But, you know, what this does not have is the cigarette factor. For me, that I'm a vapor, I don't care. You know, I'm used to it. I know how to use it. So I'm really welcoming the E-Roll to come back because it's a round factor, like the banana that Phil was deep-throating in that picture. I love it. You were ready for that. But anyway.
I didn't expect that. Dimitri, it's amazing. Like I'm telling you, you guys have heard me say this before. I can do nothing, even somewhat slightly embarrassing, without that damn cell. He's this way. Without that damn cell phone coming out and like capturing the moment for all of you to enjoy.
We are seriously considering about buying body cameras that the police officers use. To have on us constantly, so they'll run like 24 hours a day while we're out and about, while we're traveling, because half the stuff that happens is not being captured. Half the stuff that's being happened we cannot show in public, but the other half that can be shown in public, most of it is not being captured because it happens so spontaneously. So we're thinking about wearing actually body cameras like the police officers do to be able to film us 24/7. Anyway, so
To be honest with you, I'm quite excited for that new E-roll to come out. That is something that I would absolutely be interested in reviewing and taking a look at.
I cannot wait for it to come out. But we do have some hardware segments for you ready. And I wanted to start with a little device first before we get into the gala. And Yash from Vaporgate contacted us.
I'm going to go get my coffee. You talk. Put yourself on the big screen.
Wow. And
I'm
going to go get my coffee. Anything else that you want? But anyway.
There you go. There you go.
Yash from Vaporgate contacted us about this new device, the Pug that he created. And I saw it at a show a couple months ago, and I was really excited just to kind of show it to you for a couple of reasons. But I think one of the main reasons what I love about this device, aside that it has a built-in battery and some of the other features that it has, is that it's very, very simple. And I'm all about simple. When you're designing with smokers or people that are converting, don't know what TC control is, what TCR value is, what nickel is, what stainless steel is. Oh, by the way, if you're going to use nickel, there's a possibility you might, you know, use stainless steel. And if you're going to use stainless steel, it might be 316L. And, you know, they just don't know. And I'm all about simple. And that's the reason why we're showing it to you on the show today. If it was something that was really intricate, we wouldn't get into it. But I'm really, really excited to talk about the Pug, right? The Pug feel.
Yes, the Pug. I'm setting stuff up here.
Wow, you're so slow. You're so very, very slow. But anyway, the Pug has a built-in battery, and it's a device that Phil's going to do a little unboxing on it, and then we're going to talk about it here briefly. Are you ready, Phil?
An unboxing of the
Pug.
By the way, Dimitri was supposed to do these tonight.
I don't want to hear it.
I'm not ready. My stuff isn't ready. My close-up cam isn't ready. All right, so I'm ready. Let's take a look at the Pug. And you know me, right? You know me. I can't say good without saying bad. So we got to talk about a couple things here. But anyway, this is the box that the Pug comes in from Vaporgate. And, you know, if I take a look here, take a look at the box, right? And I take a look at the back. Usually at the back of the box, what you're going to see is like, I don't know, like maybe the contents and the features and everything. But this is, even though it's simple, it's clearly aimed at vapors.
Yeah.
right? I mean, this shouldn't be here. To me, this should not be here. This should be what's in the box and what are the features, all right?
Yeah.
So anyway, there's that. So we open up the box and here's the device. Very simple little internal battery device. They've got some design aesthetics here. The unique thing about this, a whole lot of venting on this side. But what's unique about this device is three charge ports.
Yeah, yeah. That's a really, really cool feature.
So this is going to use micro USB right there. This is going to use USB-C right there. And I think that's like a fire.
That's a lightning, yeah, from an Apple, basically an Apple, yeah.
Yeah, for an Apple, okay. And now here's something else that kind of bugs me. It says, it warns you, do not use more than one at a time.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So what's what am I gonna do first when I'm testing this device?
You're gonna plug all three of them in.
Hell yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Right. But we take a look. We got a nice little stainless steel platform up here.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Right. And then we have the fire button. It's gonna be a 5-click activation. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's gonna turn it on. We see plug on there on the screen, and then we have wattage. Right.
Yeah.
And I start really going through this, and I'm looking at this, and I'm like, all right, so we got 5 watts as the minimum. We are adjusting in 1 watt increments up and down. Mm-hmm. I don't like that. And again, when I took a look at a recent device too, where it adjusted also in 1 watts up and down, even in the lower wattage range, right? That makes me believe that the people who designed this aren't thinking about low wattage vapors, correct, right? Because one of the things that I like to do, and I will do when I'm vaping a low wattage, is I will maybe not be too concerned with 0.1 watt increment adjustments, but definitely at least 0.5
yeah,
watt, right? And that's something that I would like to see from this device. But I start playing with this and I'm doing all kinds of different key sequences and trying to figure out what else it has. And you're looking at it, folks. This is it. If I hold both of these buttons at the same time, we do have a system lock. Okay, so that's going to lock the system. I'm not able to fire it and use it anymore because it is locked, and I can unlock it by clicking the up and the down button. But nothing else I have found that makes this any more complicated than just a simple variable wattage device that still shows you the voltage that's going to be applied to give you your wattage and the resistance once you attach an atomizer to it. And this is the white one that I was using before.
Yeah, pretty simple device. 2,800 milliamp hour battery that's built in, which is something that we always suggest for new people without going to an external batteries. I think having an internal battery is very, very important for people that are starting out. It just makes it easier for them. It's safer for them. This, of course, the fact that you have the three charging ports, you know, I always carry, I mean, all my phones are micro USB-C, and I like the fast charging, and I just prefer using that. So it's nice to have a device that uses that. It's not the only device that uses micro USB-C. There's a couple devices coming out, including one from us, but it's just USB-C. This gives you the option to use any pretty much cable that you're going to have laying around. So that's really, really interesting. It does have these little plugs that come inside the package for you to close up the holes that you're not using, which, by the way, are going to be lost, you know, immediately. The other thing that I like inside it, it does have a cable. Yeah, those plugs, I mean, there's just no way you're going to, especially when I'm traveling, those plugs are going to be lost immediately. But I do like the cable that comes with it. I thought that was really interesting as well, too. They give you a USB cable that has all three outlets on there as well, too, right?
Yeah, you know what? I'm actually not a fan of that. Here's why I'm not a fan of that, okay? What they should have done is given you a single plug with two adaptors for it.
Yeah, okay? It's probably cheaper this way, though.
Right, but when they give you...
This is China we're talking about.
Right, but when they give me these three, the first thing I'm going to do is plug all three in. Mm-hmm. That's why I think a single with adapters would have been a smarter thing to do. And the reason why, yeah, sure, there's a warning in there saying not to plug multiples in and charge it all the time. A lot of people don't read manuals, okay? A lot of people don't understand, you know, the dangers of doing something like that. That is why, you know, one of the first things that I'm going to do is really plug all three in, and not even this way. I mean, I'm going to take a micro USB, I'm going to take a USB-C, I'm just going to plug everything in and see what happens. Because if the design is intelligent, I should be able to do that and still be safe.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you're designing products like this, you have to take into account all the stupid things that people are going to do, right? So I think that's something important that I need to do.
Yeah, and I think it's very important. And I know Yash personally. He's a good friend of mine. But we have to be honest when we're talking about these devices. And I'm sure that he appreciates the honesty. I love the form factor. You know, I love small devices that have really good battery, especially at my levels of vaping. This build that I have, I'm using it with a K-Fun Lite, the new one. I'm going to take this to Germany with me as well, too, to continue to use it. But, you know, I've got this at 1.36 build in this K-Fun Lite. Wow. Wow. I'm really going low resistance compared to the pod systems of 2 ohms going out there, right? I'm just living on the edge. But so I have a 1.36 ohm build here, and I'm running it at 18 watts. So I can get an entire day out of this battery and this setup. So I love the fact that it's small. I love the fact that it has the different charging ports. No matter what I have with me, I'm going to be able to charge it. I do like the form factor. I do like the button, even though it's completely flush. It's just raised just enough to know exactly where it's at when I put my finger over it. What I don't like about it, just like Phil said, I don't like the fact that I think that the charging ports could have been done a little bit better. You know, maybe we could have put them, you know, on the bottom so you don't have those three holes that are kind of on the side. Aesthetically, that kind of unpleases me. And the other pet peeve that I have with this device is the buttons. They're very, very loose. You can actually hear them, Phil.
Yeah. I'll do it up on here on my microphone.
Yeah, I don't like that the buttons are loose. And that's one of my big pet peeves with any kind of device. When I pick it up, I like to have the, you know, the firmness of it. This is a very, very small device. And, you know, when I pick it up, I hear it's shaking over there, and that kind of bugs me. But I'm going to use it in Germany as well, too, and throughout my trip and follow up on it. But, you know, overall, it's a really neat idea, and we're all about showing neat ideas. And I love the fact that it's simple. It is simple. And that is the most impressive thing about this device, the fact that I can just, you know, just pick it up and just vape it. Don't have to worry about any kind of different settings going on my device and anything like that. And I do appreciate simple, especially when we're recommending it to new vapers.
Yeah, one thing that I noticed here, like you talk about the aesthetics of it. So I think what they tried to do is they tried to match the vent ports on this side with the charge ports on this side.
Yeah.
To kind of keep it symmetrical.
Yeah.
Another thing that I didn't like about the package is that there is absolutely no manual anywhere to be found in my package. I'm assuming that is because this is pre-market. And then the other thing that I noticed as I was doing this, especially doing the close-ups, dude, my Zenith is beat to shit. And, you know, you would think that the guy that is, like, behind the Zenith would just go into his garage and pick out a brand new one. Yeah. But no, this is my baby. This is, like, one of the first ones that came out.
It works. Just like you, you don't have to be aesthetically pleasing as long as you get the job done, you know?
That's absolutely right. You know, this is not nicks and scratches. This is love, right?
Yeah. That Zenith has been all over the world, man. It probably has about 100,000 miles underneath its belt.
Let me go find the Chroma that this goes with. I'll go find it.
Great. Thanks. Just thinking. Yeah, by the way, let me just pull this up on a website as well, too, if you want to see the price. I just pulled up the VaporGate website. $63.99, a little bit on the high side for this kind of device. I'd like to see it a little under $50, but it is what it is. I'm not here to dictate the prices and tell you what you want to pay or not. But around $63 is on the VaporGate side, as these Vapor DNAs and My Vapor Stores and all these websites get them in. I'm sure that the price is going to come down a little bit as well too. So yeah, that's the VaporGate Pug.
Yeah, look at my Zenith. Look at my Chroma rather is so beat. This is going on 2 years. This thing right here. And look what I did. I laser engraved the Smoker Show into the handle.
Yeah, it looks horrible, but that was a good effort.
This is the one that I used to hammer the other pin out of.
It did. But yeah, we appreciate Yash at the VaporGate for sending over the pugs for us to test out. And we'll see him in Germany as well, too. So I'll be using it and give him some more feedback. Hopefully he'll take it. He'll take it the, you know, as constructive criticism, because that's exactly what it's supposed to be. What are you drinking?
My coffee.
All right. Let me get a couple questions from the chat. Real quick, are you coming out with a 4 milliliter slide? Absolutely not. And why not, Phil?
We can't, guys. That was explained very clearly in the introduction video that we did on the slide. The slide is not designed to be a replacement for the Zenith. It is a more cost effective design. It doesn't have the liquid shutoff. So that's key right there. It does not have the liquid shutoff on it. Okay. So if we go to a larger capacity, the potential exists that when you open it up to top fill, it's going to flood the coil and it's going to gurgle. And we don't want that to happen to you guys with the design, with the tank, right? So the slide will always be a 2 milliliter tank. The Zenith will always be available in a 4 milliliter. And hint, hint, we are doing something new with the Zenith besides the new Zenith colors that are coming out.
Yeah, I think it's important for people to understand that the platform series of products are designed to give a good experience to the person that's converting. Getting liquid in your mouth, getting dry hits, getting burnt coils is not a pleasurable experience. So it's designed to be 2 mls. There's a reason behind it, and that is to give a good pleasurable experience to somebody that's trying it out for the first time. All right, one more little break, and then we're going to get into the gala. Speaking of gala, that's what I've got set up, a little 30-second video introducing the gala. And in some very, very, very lovely colors, Mr. Phil, do you have an unboxing ready for us for the gala?
Look, there it is.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. Good timing. Good timing.
Much better that time. I got to raise my camera up here a little bit. I'm going to do the best that I can with this. So here is the box that the new Inikin gala comes in. And this is going to be, and we'll talk about why, this is going to be a little bit of a different product for Inikin. Okay, you see gala on this. Look, see, this is the way you do a back of a box, right? So you've got what's in here. You got some warnings. You got the usual scratch and snip authenticity sticker. No. Didn't you tell them that they don't have to do this? Did you tell them that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I can't. I don't own Inikin, by the way. I just want to put that out there. Because I tell them doesn't mean it's going to happen.
And they do. Like, this is not a sticker. They do actually have the color of the device as part of the box. So it's box is printed differently. So this is going to be the blue sapphire, I believe. So we take it out, and there it is. You know, as usual with Inikin products, it's a very professional display, very Apple-like, right? On this side, we're going to have all kinds of goodies. We are going to have, see, this is neat. Okay, so these are tip adapters to maybe help you get the e-liquid into the gala. Mm-hmm. Here, we're going to have a spare pod. Now, you were telling me that this pod is different from the other pod.
Yeah, the one with the green is meant for CBD or other thicker substances. Yeah.
Right. Here we have a whole bunch of instructions here. This is the manual, some information about using that tip with your bottle, again, to make it a little bit easier to fill, even though this is no more difficult than any of the other plug type devices that are out there. Of course, we're going to have this, which is going to have the warning and safety guide. This is going to be your warranty card, a battery care guide. And then the device itself, and here is the device itself in the blue. A little bit of a fingerprint magnet here, but they definitely went with the glossy look. And I can hope you can see how the blue kind of fades into a black as we work our way down.
Sexy.
So here's the pod on this device. And when I say pod, I say a pod in the true sense of the word. Okay, this is a open system pod. Okay, so which means that you can fill it with your own e-liquid, but it is a pod in the sense that the coil is part of the pod. So when the coil is spent, the pod goes out with it into the garbage. It's not like you can replace the coil on this one. It's all incorporated into one piece. So I have been using one here. This is the one that I've been using. This is the black one, and I can show you the filling. Now, I'm not a fan of the plugs.
Me neither.
Right? But they actually did something pretty smart here. They have a little lip right there, okay? And that lip hangs over just a little bit.
Yeah.
So you just flip it open, okay? You just flip it open just like
that.
Okay, and that's how you get to the fill port. Can you guys see that okay? Am I holding it the right way?
Yeah, it's okay.
So not bad, okay? You still get liquid a little bit over your fingers. It's easy to close again, but that is how you fill. Do you know the size of the pot on this one, Dave?
It's a 1.8, I want to say.
1.8?
Yeah.
Okay. And you'll notice that the pod does only go in one way. Okay. So if we take a look at the battery section of this, there is an angle on here. Okay. So one side is higher than the other. And you just kind of match that up here. You can see this is higher here, a little bit lower here. So that's how this goes on. clicks into place just like that. There's an LED bar on this one, and to change the LED colors, because you can do that, the LED also indicates the battery power, but you tap this one. So if I tap it three times, one, two, three, that should light up, and you can see it's lighting up blue now. And if you shake it, you can go to the different available colors. So there's a purple, there's a red, and once you have the color selected that you want to use, you can go ahead and either puff on it or just let it time out. So this is kind of like a
4 second timeout,
right? And then it'll time out and it'll lock that color in.
I love the way you shake it, by the way. I just want to put
it. Like that? You like that? I'm shaking it like a Polaroid picture.
Yeah.
There's also a party mode. If I tap it five times, so one, two, three, four, five, it's just going to start going through all the colors. Okay, so this is party mode. This is, hey, let's have a party while we're vaping, right?
Yeah.
And you know, some people think like the colors and the LEDs and everything, a little gimmicky, maybe even childish. I like them. I've always liked colors, and I've always liked lighting, and I've always liked LEDs. And to be honest with you, I don't think this is really over the top. I think it's really kind of well done. Right?
I have to agree with you. I think it's a very, very good looking pod system. I'm using two currently here. I have, of course, the Dimitri pink, and then I have the midnight blue to black, which is my favorite color combination of all those colors that you saw in the video earlier. What I have noticed with this, it does use a 0.5 Plexus style coil, pretty much kind of what we've seen on the EQ and all that. But keep in mind that this only has one wattage output, unlike the EQ, which has the three variable wattages, so you can just boost it up a little bit if you want to, especially if you're using regular nicotine. So in this particular pod, I find myself wanting to use the 20 milligram refined nicotine and salt combination that I normally use if I want like a higher nicotine intake when I'm traveling and I can't vape a lot. I find it to be more satisfying in the Gala than with regular 12 milligram freebase liquid.
Yeah. And there is, you'll notice here on the other side of the device, there is a standard micro USB-C charge port on it as well.
And keep in mind, and I'll just go back to your normal shot. And you know, what I find really interesting with these automatic switches is, just like any other pod system that's out there, when you have an automatic switch, you have to give it a little primer puff. It just takes a little bit, you know, just to heat up that liquid inside. So basically what I do is kind of like, you know, a cigarette type draw. I take one puff and I don't inhale, and then I take a second puff and I fully inhale it. That way it heats up that coil a little bit quicker. But other than that, I think it's a really good looking device. Micro USB on the side. You can charge it and vape it at the same time. You do have a battery indicator. It will flash twice when the battery is between 40% and 20%, and then it'll flash three times after using it to let you know that the battery is under 20% in order for you to use it. And the LED does go up depending what color you have chosen. I have the blue one here hitting on the pink, and then I think on this one I have the blue one as well too.
Yeah, and you know, too, when you sit the pod on the device, it also shows you the charge of the battery.
Yeah, absolutely.
You don't have to wait, but
bottles like this is a 10 mil bottle from Europe. This is a 20 milligram from Diamond Mist Double Apple that I've been enjoying a lot. No problems with this. Even some of my 30 mil bottles that I use, this is the Silk Nick that I use most of the time. I haven't had any problem filling it. It is a little bit finicky, like all those little small systems, right? All those little salts. It's going to be sometimes you can get liquid on your hands. So you have to be aware of that, and we have to be honest about when we're talking about these products. But other than that, I think it's a nice addition to the pod offering that Inikin has out there right now.
I do. I think it's classy looking. I think it's got a very, very solid feel to it. It's extremely solid feeling. The one thing that I noticed from using this is, and I said this is a little bit of a break from the normal Inikin product. And why is that? Because I think up to this point, every one of the Inikin products that have come out have been satisfying up to a 12 milligram standard nicotine, right? Yeah. I think this is the first one that really kind of falls into that pod category, where if you really want to be satisfied with a standard nicotine, I think you're going to be happier around an 18. Or this is going to be a salt type device.
But also keep in mind that they're keeping up with the trends, and CBD seems to be a big trend with the vape shops, whether me and Phil agree with it or not. A lot of vape shops are bringing in CBD because you know, supplement income because they're not getting enough smokers inside, unfortunately. So they do offer you a pod that is meant, you know, with a ceramic coil that is meant for CBD as well, too, or anything else that you want to use in this. So they are offering this pod, and it comes along in the box. So you get the regular pod for regular, you know, nicotine that you're going to be using inside. And, of course, you do get a CBD pod with it as well, too, if that's what you choose. So it gives you a little bit more variety for the vape stores if you're selling a lot of CBD or vapeable CBD in your stores as well, too.
Yeah, I tell you what, I used this all night at the neighborhood fish fry that I was invited to. Very, very nice, by the way.
Yeah.
And I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I had the 20 milligram Silk Nick.
Yeah.
From Lavop Shop, the coffee vanilla that I really enjoy, and worked just fine. Worked just fine.
Yeah, I had to bump up because I always like to try my stuff with tobacco, obviously, you know, to recommend. I used 18 milligram BLK from Lunar Rover, and it was a good vape. But anything lower than that, like a 12 milligram, I didn't get enough of the throat hit like I do like in a Zenith tank or something like that out of it to give me that same satisfaction.
Right, exactly right. And I could even say that about like the Anakin EQ or the EQS, the fact that the EQ has two power levels. I think the EQS has three power levels, right?
Correct.
And if you crank those up to the higher power levels, I think they're more satisfying with a standard nicotine free base than this, right? But again, this has its place in the market now. And yeah. I think it's a really well-made device.
Yeah. By the way, I think that Dan Donahue did go to counseling and the counselor told him to use CBD.
Yeah.
Because it cures everything. Because it cures everything.
CBD just works for everything. I mean, it cures everything. It'll cure Dan's relationship issues. It'll cure everything out there, folks.
Yeah. No, not necessarily. CBD is a little bit different. I think that 80-20 VG liquid is completely different than CBD. It's not so much this viscosity of the VG that clogs down. It's actually the CBD raw material that's being used to create the CBD formulation that bogs down a lot of the coils that are on the market right now. All right, we got to answer a few questions that are out there. Good night, everybody.
Let's answer some questions.
Can you dilute salt nicotine with a PG? Yes, absolutely you can. Yeah, and most of the salt nicotines are mixed in a 50-50 kind of a mix as well, too. So if dilute, you mean to cut down on the nicotine or whatever, you know, that's probably a chemist question to use, but you certainly can add PG to salt nicotines. Yeah. I don't think it's going to be a problem.
Can I ask a question? My question is, why are people vaping 3 milligram salt nicotine?
I have no idea. Maybe it's more satisfying to them than 3 milligram regular. I really don't know. I don't know the answer. I don't. I think it's just because it's the hype. Salt nicotine is the new black. It's just like the new donut. It's just something that people are asking.
You know how many emails I get about people asking me, I want to try salt nicotine. What do you think about it? And I ask them, why do you want to try salt nicotine? And they say, I have no idea, but it seems
no clue. Yeah, everybody's doing it. So that's why I want to do it. Okay. Question. I never got a coherent answer to when I began vaping in 2013. Why did all the reviewers recommend to charge a mod from a charger and not from a computer, laptop, et cetera? That's a question for you, Mr. Tech Busardo.
Well, I think, first of all, probably stability of the power coming out of a laptop. Now, a little bit different, though. Now, with the USB 3.1 standard, I think you're going to have a more stable power. You're going to have a higher power coming out of your laptop. But I know even some of the Inikin products, if they don't get enough power from the a laptop or a computer, they get a little funky. They get a little funky until you plug them into enough power, and then they'll come right back. I'm guessing that's the reason. If Mooch is still here, he will definitely know the answer. I think that was more of a problem with older technology.
Correct.
Than it is today with the current USB standards that are out there.
Some of the Chinese chipsets back in the day were not, how can I put this lightly? They were not, not so much the chipset itself, but the chip that's being used to balance charge the batteries. That was a huge problem back in the day. And I think as technology has evolved and the Chinese companies have caught up to the technology to balance charge batteries in the device, it has gotten better. I always suggest that. It's just a safety thing more than anything else. But using the proper equipment to charge your stuff is very, very highly recommended.
Yeah. You know what? Before we get to the next question, let's ask Holly a couple questions. So Holly smokes Camel Blue 99s. And the question to Holly was, is that a menthol? So Holly, Go ahead and answer that question. A camel blue, is it, does that mean like it's a light? I'm not familiar with the camel
I'm
brand.
I'm not sure what the camel blue 99 is either.
Okay, so Holly, here's what I want you to do. I want you to describe what camel blue 99 means. Okay, so we can figure out what it is that we're going to send you. No USB. Yeah.
Problem solved. Absolutely, yeah, Moji. Sure. Yeah.
There you go. That'll solve everything. Okay, so the blue is like a light. So it's a light. Okay, so that's good. So that means 12 milligram, not 18, is going to come your way. Tobacco. What do you want to do for a product? Do you want to do a T18 for Holly, or do you want to do a...
I think an Innocent Chroma with a Zenith and some 12 milligram tobacco liquid.
Oh, we're gonna go big for Holly. Very, very nice.
Okay. Big for Holly because big she's still Holly. Smoking.
Right. And Holly, we're gonna send you some. I'm gonna put together a little package for you. We're gonna send you a Chroma with a Zenith. I think you're gonna love it. We're also going to put together some liquid. We're going to send you some Lunar Rover tobaccos in a 12 milligram. Mm-hmm. And we're also going to send you some Naked. Not naked. We're not going to send you Dimitri Naked. That will do nothing for your smoking habit.
Although there is a picture. You might see it in a book one day. There is a picture of my butt cheeks that Phil took in China.
I can't believe you're sharing that right now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's just enticing people to buy the book. I'm just fishing. I'm just putting it out there. You want to go? You're gonna want to buy this book for various reasons, and seeing my butt cheeks is probably gonna be just a valid reason for you to buy the book.
Absolutely.
And Steven Sard says if you have to use a cube to charge, use an Apple Cube or a cube from Anker. Clean, power, and smooth at a constant rate. That is over 10 years of electronics experience. So take Steven's word for it. He's got 10 years of electronic experience. Yeah, so thank you, Steven.
I typically charge off of a computer port, but off of a plug or some other kind of USB output power.
Yeah, I don't do it. Maybe if it's a small pot, I'll pop it into a computer if I need to or whatever. But I generally always have a charging port here. You can't see it. Let me see if I can move my camera. I have a charging port here that I charge all my stuff. Just try to keep everything nice and safe and clean. And then I have another one that's set up on my desk over here.
Well, this desk that I'm using right now, actually, it goes up and down. Nobody knows that. I don't think anybody knows that. It goes up and down, and it has USB ports on the side of it.
Yeah.
See, like if I push this button right here, it's going to eventually block my camera. Look at that. Look at that.
Wow.
Isn't that cool?
That is some digital stuff right there.
And you know why I don't have that? Because when I do close-ups in the review videos.
I know why you do that.
I like to do them standing up. That's why.
When you're pleasuring yourself, people don't hack your camera. That's why you do that. Holly is going to let her boyfriend try it. Hey, Holly, if your boyfriend likes it, then you can go buy a Chroma and a Zenith as well, too. So
wait a second. Hold on. Holly, do you have a boyfriend?
He uses a pod, and he uses a 50 milligram, and it hurt her throat. So.
Oh, okay. So this is good. This is good. Holly, what I need you to do, though, answer me this. Are you on Facebook? If you're on
Facebook, who's not on Facebook today?
I want you to get a hold of me on Facebook and get me your shipping information. If you are not on Facebook, Bill Tarling is about to put my my email address in there. You get a hold of me at email. The one thing I'm going to try to put this in a place where it can get shipped this week.
Yeah.
If I can't make that happen, you're going to have to hold on until we get back.
Well, you don't leave until 12 tomorrow. I leave at 5. So I still have to get the EQ out. I'm going to print and put it in a box and give it to my wife to ship out tomorrow. But anyway.
We have to announce that?
We're going to do it tonight. We're going to do it live here on the show.
Do it live.
What do you think about the Truth Org commercials that are making a big deal about vapes having X amount of cigarettes in a tank? I think that the Truth.org is a lie. That's what I think. I think it's fake news. And don't worry about the nicotine content.
So it should be a lie.org.
It's a lie.org. We got a telephone call.
Right.
We got a telephone call, Mr. Phil Bisardo.
Telephone call.
602, you're on the air with Phil and Dimi. If you can just turn down your stream so we don't hear you. 602. All right. 602.
I'll get there. It's the delay.
No, I mean, he should be hearing this from the phone line if they're listening to the phone line.
602. You are live.
Well, at least I can hear the stream from 602. So, all right. Nope.
No 602. Any other callers?
Mm.
What time? Yeah, it's funny. You said we weren't going to go long tonight, but we only have half an hour left.
I know.
25 minutes left.
I know I said it, but but it always works out like that. All right, let me go ahead and do the giveaway. And for those of you that are not part of the platform group, you should be part of the platform group, because in the platform group, you get to see a lot of cool stuff. We have stuff that that we do that we announce there before we announce it anywhere else. We have a support, obviously, for our products, meaning the products that we manufacture with Inakin. So it's a really, really cool place to hang out. All you gotta do is just search Platform Series Manufactured by Inakin Help Group on Facebook, and then just put a little request to come in. Today, I did a really nice, cool giveaway. This, of course, is the limited edition Phil and Dimitri mugshot Inakin EQS. We actually printed this up while we were in China. And we offered one to the group, and there was a lot of comments underneath there. To participate, all you had to do is really just tag Phil Busardo. And I know that Phil was busy today, so I figured what better way to have fun with Phil than to have everybody tag him. And one of the things about Phil is he's always concerned about drama. Phil is always, he just does not like drama. He doesn't want to be involved with it. So when you see yourself being tagged somewhere on Facebook for like 50 times, the first thing that goes in your mind is like, oh my God, something went wrong. There's drama going on, so I got to go check it.
But and the other problem is because for some reason I have Verizon, okay? And where I am in Florida, Verizon doesn't work very well, okay? Yeah, yeah. So my phone pulls every now and then, right? I'll get to an area and all of a sudden my phone will pull and then it'll update everything, right? Yeah. So I'm walking around and all of a sudden my phone's like ding, 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 ding. I'm looking at it. I'm seeing all the, I'm like, oh Christ, what did I do now? What's going on? Where's the drama, right? And sure enough, it was Dimitri being a funny guy.
Yeah, I thought it was really, really funny. But anyway, we are going to give this away today. And like I said, just jump in the group if you're not there. And, you know, if you didn't partake in this one, you definitely can partake on the next giveaway that we're going to do. But here are all the names that that took place in the contest there. And I'm going to randomize this list. And the first person on this list, hopefully in the United States of America.
I'll have to
reload my stamps.com account. And the big winner is.
Come on, North Korea. Come on.
Jarno Pross. That is not.
That's not America. That is not sounding
very, very good for me.
Jarno, that's not American.
That
Yay,
does not sound very good for me. So Jarno Pross, congratulations.
I love when it costs you $100 to ship a $20 item. I love it.
That is some BS. That sounds like it's going to be somewhere in the Philippines, by the way. But Jarno Pross, send me a message on Facebook. You have to do it literally in the next 6 hours, because I will be leaving for a flight and I will ship it out to you tomorrow morning or whenever it's going to get to Kazakhstan or wherever you live, because it doesn't sound like you're in the United States.
That's funny.
I'm sorry, Dan. You can always call back if you want to. Sorry. Is that you? Was that you? 602? Dan, is 602 you? Hold on, let me check his number.
Dan shouldn't be 602. He should be 973, no?
That's what I thought so too. Hold on, let me check. Dan. He just texted me the other day to make sure. Dan, yeah, it's not. No, his Dan's 845. So, I don't know.
Really?
602 is back on there. Let me see if he's back on there. Let me see if we can take the call. 602, can you hear us?
We'll do it live.
602.
Come on.
I mean, they just want to hear our voice on the telephone, I think. That's all. Anyway.
Come on, 602.
He's not answering.
There's a big delay.
Well, I mean, that's generally how the internet works, Phil. I know, especially even more so in Cape Coral. There's like a 3-day delay for you to get the stream.
It's like calling Mars.
I love it. But anyway, Dan, if you want to call in. 602 is not answering, so I don't know what to tell him. I really don't. I don't want to feel like we're ignoring them, but...
You know what we're going to do? I think the next show we start off with... like
602, can you hear us? Hello?
Can finally hear.
Yeah, hey, 602, who's this?
This is Mark.
Hey, Mark, what's
AKA
going on?
AKA AV Advocate.
Oh, okay, what's going on, Mark?
Not much, I just wanted to give them a little bit of an update that the legislature finished up here, and I wanted to thank the guys for giving me the inspiration to battle the legislature on vaping bill.
Well, we certainly appreciate it. I got your email today, and I replied to it, and I know that you guys there in Arizona did a really good job this year. And, you know, advocating for this product is something that we try to motivate, you know, through a personal level and, of course, on a social media level. So for those of you that don't know that, you know, Mark had a lot of medical issues, and I don't know if you want to talk about it, Mark, but, you know, he discovered vaping and just, you know, got inspired and became a huge advocate for the product. And I wish more people would follow his story.
Well, about a year ago, I had issues with circulation in my leg and had some surgery, and my wife told me I had to quit smoking. So I tried blue and then eventually worked my way up to vaping. In fact, I had written you about building an OBS engine early on. But shortly after that, in May, I lost my right leg. And I was on the school board at the time, had to leave it. So got in the legislature and dealing with vaping gave me something to do.
That's awesome to hear, Mark. And yes, and we certainly appreciate you taking the time to do that and going over there and talking to the officials. And, you know, I'm sorry about your medical condition, but, you know, that's not a reason to stop. And the fact that you're getting out there and getting involved shows that that if you can do it, certainly anybody can do it, especially able-bodied people, right?
Right. No excuses.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I couldn't make it down to the Capitol, but I got involved with somebody that you pointed me to with Arizona Smoke Free Association down out here. And so between the two of us, we were able to hammer away, and looks like we got a weakened bill that didn't stop everything. So I think we accomplished a lot.
That's fantastic, Mark. We certainly appreciate it. Keep advocating and keep fighting for this product, and we're always here to help you.
I will. And by the way, day 500, so milestone. So thank you guys very much.
Rock on, buddy. 500. That sounds good. So all of you that are smokers out there, take Mark's example. He's on day 500. Thank you, Mark. Day 500 of being smoke-free. And that's just a wonderful, wonderful story to hear. And I know you only heard him from the left channel. That is because the phone lines are on the mono channel tonight. Unfortunately, didn't have time to fix it because I have been very, very busy. But, you know, hopefully the next episode I'll have it stereo for you guys that are really complaining about the audio about it. But at least we got to hear him and we got the message. And that's the most important part of that story. Right, Phil?
Absolutely. I think that's terrific what he's doing. And, you know, it gave him something else to do. It gave him something, you know, you can get into vaping as much as or as little as you want to. There are so many different ways to vape. You can really kind of get into it. You can get into the advanced side with a device that has a lot more features and functions. You can get into it as simple as, you know, a filled pod that you don't have to really do anything. But when the e-liquid is out of the pod, you take it out and you throw it away and you put a new pod on. There's so many different ways you can do this thing that we do. It could become a hobby. It could become a pastime. It could give you something to do. You can get more involved with advocacy and go to some of the hearings and make your voice heard. You know, but if you do have the opportunity, do something, even if it's just one day you call up your senator and say, you know what, I vape and I don't want you to take it away from me. Right.
Yeah.
I think that's important.
Yeah.
I think that's important. Yeah. That everybody does something.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm sorry. Ginger was pounding the speaker. That's just a little trickery that we do here. Just make you pound.
She was trying to get make the speaker work. Is that what she was doing?
That's what she was trying to do. All right. Let me show we covered all the questions before we wrap it up. Beal removed a message. I don't know what that was. Probably nothing important. Okay. I don't see any more questions. Just programming note. Keep a track of our social media. Follow me on Instagram at Vaping Greek for the giveaway. Of course, obviously, we're going to give away a bunch of starter kits for World Anti-Tobacco Day, May 31st. Keep in mind that if you do, whenever I finish that giveaway, it'll be after June 10th when I ship them because I will be traveling to Europe with Phil for the next 10 days. But follow our social media, facebook.com/Phil Busardo or Vaping Greek. That way you can keep posted on the lives that we're going to be doing from the Smoker Show, from Portugal, from Spain. We'll try to give you a little video. And, of course, we're going to shoot a bunch of video there that we're going to edit when we come back and kind of break it down here in the next couple episodes of the Smoker Show. But the Smoker Show will be back in 2 weeks from tonight. So we'll try to track on schedule. Of course, last week we missed the episode because we were both traveling to New Jersey. And, yeah, traveling is rough, guys. I mean,
it is.
People think that we live this elaborate, glamorous life of traveling. There is nothing elaborate of me in my underwear ironing Phil Busardo's shirt at 9 o'clock in the morning while his mom walks in the room. You know, I mean, there's really nothing glamorous about that at all.
funny.
Yeah, it is really difficult when we're traveling, trying to keep up with the content. But we're very committed to the Smoker Show. This is episode 31. That means that you have 30 other chances to go back and look at some replays of episodes that you haven't seen. So either, you know, you might not catch it live, but you might be able to go back and see some of the episodes and get some more information.
And, you know, for people like who joined us tonight, Holly, okay, Holly was asking some very, and believe me, there's no such thing as a stupid question, Holly. And as we get these questions, we really do like to answer them, even if we have to answer them hundreds and hundreds of times, which we do in some cases, right? But we never take for granted what we know about vaping, and we want to share that with everybody. We always have to remember that somewhere in this world is picking up an electronic cigarette for the very first time, and they have no idea. They have no idea what we know. They have no idea what temperature control means. They have no idea what resistance is, what wattage is. They don't know. Okay.
Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons why this show is here. But a lot of the basic stuff we did cover in the earlier shows, right? And I think we do need to do a recap show every now and then where we do start to go over some of that stuff for people exactly like you, Holly, who are joining us for the first time. But if you do have the opportunity, do check out those earlier shows because there's a lot of information packed in those shows that I think would be very valuable to somebody who's just getting into this now.
Yeah, and Holly, once you get the Chroma and the liquid and you try it out, give us a call and let's just talk you through it. Let us know what worked and what didn't work. I think feedback is very, very important for us. It's something that we long for when we do give away these kits. And listen, we solely understand that some people are going to take advantage of this just to get a free device. We do. We get it. But that's not going to deter us from our goal, and that is to help people convert smokers. And, you know, it is what it is. Nothing we can do about that. There's a question. I have a question. Why haven't you guys done shows in the United States? Or maybe I haven't seen them, but would like to know. We do a lot of shows in the United States. We've never done a smoker show because all the shows, with the exception of the Vapors Carnival that is dedicated to help smokers quit, I wish they would fine tune that a little bit. Because I say, this is going to create drama, but when a show says, we converted 270 smokers, come on, that's not necessarily true. You might have given away 270 kits, but we really need to get data. And the only way that you can get data is to make sure that you get feedback from the people that are getting this. And for our goal for the Smoker Show, doing it live, is to continue helping these people with a support group, a Q&A, feedback, constant emails. So none of the other shows, with the exception of Vapors Carnival, I'll say that because I have to give them credit, none of the other shows care about smokers. They don't. All they care about is vapors and marketing and pushing the latest and the greatest to the vaping community. So you'll see us at those shows. If Anakin tells us to be it, we were Vape Event New York. We were, what's the other show that we did here in the U.S.? A month ago. Where were we?
New York was a month ago.
And after New York, didn't we do another show here in the U.S.?
I don't remember what I did.
Yeah, anyway, so we do go to shows here in the United States, to promote our products. And if Anakin tells us to go, if we're invited, like the VMX in Tampa, we're invited to give a presentation there. We will be at ECC in California doing the workshop seminar for vape shops if we're invited to go. But as far as the Smoker Show live here in the United States, none of the shows have invited us to do it. So that's why you don't see it. I mean, we just don't show up and set up a booth and start giving away kits, right? I mean, there has to be promotion. There has to be people go out there and pass out flyers to smokers in that town, which is exactly what the Hall of Vape did in Germany. Went around Stuttgart to coffee shops and bars and areas where smokers hung out and passed away flyers and passed out lighters that have the show on there and invited them to come to the event. And there's a lot of work that goes into getting this done. And Ira is really stressed out about it. He wants this to go out without a hitch, trying to get volunteers, trying to get the space set up, the logos, T-shirts for the volunteers, literature that we're handing out to the smokers, questionnaires that they have to fill out. I mean, there's a lot of work that goes involved. And some promoters here in the United States, I'm not going to say any names, you know, all they care about is setting up a stripper pole. Yeah. So, you know, it is what it is.
I can't say enough about Ira and his team. They are going above and beyond to make the first Smoker Show Live a success. And I think they're doing a great job, and we didn't even see any. We're not even at the booth yet.
Yeah.
But there have been constant questions coming into us about the products that we're going to have there, because they want to make videos and instructional materials for that for the German vapers. There have been questions about what kind of products we're bringing. There have been questions about what kind of literature can we give away. Like, if people come in and they have this you know, social, what do you call mainstream media, right? You look at mainstream media and vaping is not good, right? What kind of handouts can we give to people who still think in their heads that that vaping is worse than smoking? What kind of studies can we give them? And they're doing all this stuff. They're the big banner for the booth, the backdrops, the T-shirts, everything. I mean, Ira, I can't thank you enough. You guys are really trying to set this off the right way, and we appreciate it.
Yeah, I wish we could get on Netflix. I really do wish we could get on Netflix. Trust me. We would definitely reach more smokers that way. But even in our small part of YouTube here, we're just trying to do the best. Even if we convert five people, that's a big win for us.
I agree with you. I think the bigger problem, and, you know, what we did tonight with that CNN newscast and how we showed that this is the myth. These are the bad things that are being shared. And then we take a look at what Dr. Farsalinos put out. The problem is, how many people are going to watch this?
Yeah. 3,000? A couple thousand, 3,000. Yeah.
3,000. Yeah. How many people did CNN reach with that poor information?
Millions.
That
millions.
Bad information. Millions.
Especially when it's picked up by Associated Press, which, by the way, is being used through a PR firm from our opposition. The American Heart Association has paid for these pieces to run. Don't think that CNN woke up one morning and said, well, we're going to run this story. There's media buyers behind it that push these stories to them. And the American Heart Association, of course, has a media firm that represents them here in the United States. And we're more concerned about reviewer drama and, you know, who's going to have the sexier girls at the booth. That's where we spend our money. Yeah. But anyway, and let me answer one more question really quickly. Adding nicotine will increase my throat hit? Yes. And also PG will increase your throat hit. Both of those components will increase the throat hit. So if you're not getting enough throat hit with a 6 milligram, you can try a 12 milligram, try to do a 50-50 or even a 60-40. I use a 60% PG, 40 VG mix for my all-day vape. And that allows me to use 6 milligram at a very satisfying throat hit for me. It's also a menthol, which enhances the throat hit as well. It has eucalyptus inside as well, too, which enhances the throat hit a little bit more. So my 6 milligram is probably like a 12 milligram. But increasing PG and increasing nicotine obviously is going to increase your throat hit as well, too.
Dimitri's, I keep pointing in the wrong direction. Dimitri's menthol throat hit is not a throat hit. It's a throat punch.
Yeah, it's a mule kick.
Yeah, it's terrible.
I even sub-ohm 6 milligram menthol. I sub-ohm 6 milligram menthol. I like that. That it gives me, to the throat. But anyway, yeah. And for DIY, Faro Flavor Pour, Jennifer Jarvis, and of course, Wayne Walker, which we had on the show a couple weeks ago. DIY or die vaping. If you want to get more information about DIY there. But don't forget, if you want your stuff ready mixed, we have to thank our wonderful sponsors, Mr. Feel.
We should do that. We should thank our wonderful sponsors. Inikin, the makers of the wonderful Zly tank and the Zenith tank and the Z-Beep, not to mention all of the other Inikin products that are out there. Juno, one of our latest sponsors. They have a closed pod system. We have, really? You got to put that up on the screen while I'm reading this. We have My Vapor Store, a very good online vendor. If you use coupon code, I can't read it while you're doing that. You're such an ass.
It's such a great picture, man.
MTL10 is going to get you 10% off. Naked 100, the fine folks over there at Five Pawns, Joytech, and of course, Lunar Rover. Max is always good enough to join in with the chat and help people along. I tell you what. I am really, really digging the strawberry mojito. I love the mint experience. I'm going to say a mint experience because it's not mint. It is a mint leaf. It's amazing. Do go out and try that out, okay?
I thought you enjoyed banana vapes. Enjoyed banana vapes?
No, like you could not have snapped that picture at a worse time. Yeah.
Worse? This is like perfect timing. Like it couldn't have been done any better. Have you seen those pictures where they post on Facebook where it's like timed perfectly? I'm gonna throw this in the mix. I'm gonna submit it right now.
Because I was like just opening my mouth to take that bite of delicious banana and just I began to insert the shaft into my mouth as I was opening, and it's like that was it. It was like And the picture happened.
And I hate to be that guy, but I am testing out a new product. Whoop, that's all you're going to see, but you're going to see that. That's all you so I hate to be that guy. Something has not been done before as well, too, so we're very, very excited. Maybe
Cool.
Maybe we'll be allowed to show that to you in a couple of weeks, but but we're not allowed to show it to you. Now, I have to pack. I have not packed anything, and I have to get my vape stuff in order and meet you at the airport tomorrow.
Are you going to Oh yeah, and you have to you got to leave way early too. So you're not packed at all. Are you going to pack your sexy underwear?
Yeah, I got new underwear for you.
Oh, thank
yeah,
God.
Yeah, I got new. I went
thank God.
I actually bought some new boxer briefs a couple of days ago. I found them on special. So I'm getting all brand new underwear for you. I'm going to be all fresh on this for you.
You know what? I appreciate that too, you know. Because sometimes you have the holes in the wrong place and it's just not a turn on.
Yeah, anymore. I'm sorry. But yeah, I'm getting all new underwear. I bought a couple new shirts today and I bought a new pair of jeans because you complained about my other jeans. But I got a new pair of jeans.
Those jeans are just fine when the water gets up about 3 feet.
It's stylish, buddy. It's stylish. You got to show a little ankle today. You got to get with the program. Unless you're wearing Skechers. You wanted to cover the shoe. You don't want to actually see the shoe that's out there.
No, I bought a new pair of jeans too. It's ripped in more places than I care to mention, but they are some sexy pair of jeans. Tell you what, those jeans on this 50-year-old body are going to look pretty damn good.
Awesome. I'm really, really excited to see you again.
I know you are.
And we're going to have a great time in our European travel. So thanks a lot to our sponsors. We certainly appreciate it. And of course, the Vaping Advocate magazine that sponsors our telephone lines, the only Vaping Advocate magazine out there. We certainly appreciate it. And don't forget, I was going to go with closing thoughts, but I was going to switch to you first.
Oh, I you said don't forget. And then I think you forgot.
Yeah, I did.
As always, you guys, thank you so much for joining the show. But I think the show is going to work a whole lot better with you guys spreading the word about the show and what the show is designed for and who this show is designed for. Certainly not for the youth epidemic of vaping, which really doesn't exist. There is no epidemic, but it is designed to invite smokers in and show them a healthier way for them to get their nicotine, right? So please spread the word of the show, share the show, talk about the show, invite smokers to the show. They may not be able to come in live, but maybe they could watch a replay and maybe they can see and experience a different side of vaping than they might be getting in mainstream media or even in social media, right? We're trying to put a different face on this thing that we do. So invite people. That's why we put #SmokersWanted.
Did you see my pictures from the wedding this weekend?
You look good, man.
I look really, really proper.
I think you should be a vape model.
I wish again. This is gonna sound so condescending, but it really is not meant. It's really not meant to be condescending. But what I try to do this weekend, since you know I was dressed up, you know I went to my niece's wedding, which was absolutely fantastic, and I tried to post some pictures to let people know that you know vaping is classy. It's not sometimes you see these pictures of you know. Models and all kinds of stuff, but here I am with my beep, you know, just trying to look all professional. So I hope you enjoyed that. I really, you know, was trying to just get give a different.
And not only did I enjoy that, look at me in this photo right here.
Hold on.
I have to be on the screen though. I think.
Yeah, I got it.
I think if I push this button right here.
Yeah, look at that. Who took that picture?
Some Greek guy.
Yeah, the best photographer you have on your staff is me, buddy. Don't
you can
forget.
Be classy and vape. You know, it doesn't have to be, you know, all, you know, ear gauges and tattoos. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but let's show the other side of vaping too.
Yeah.
But let's make vaping look like this for the people who need to see this.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Not just see the other side. Yes. I think that's important. I think it's, you know, we talk about balance a lot. We use that word balance a lot in the seminar that we do.
Yeah.
And I think this is the kind of balance that we need because God knows views is taking advantage of that. Okay. God knows Jewel is taking advantage of that. Why don't we take advantage of that as well?
Absolutely. And don't forget that May 31st, what is May 31st? It's World No Tobacco Day. World No Tobacco Day. This is, of course, the World Corrupt Health Organization website over here. And of course, e-cigarettes contain no tobacco. So we're going to be celebrating with them. No matter how you're going to do it, me personally, I'm in my stores in Greece. I'm giving away an EQ and some liquid. People that are going to trade in their IQOS or their cigarettes. I'm giving away some kits on Instagram as well, too. This is how I'm celebrating May 31st. And if you're a vapor, vape shop owner, liquid maker, manufacturer, distributor, or just a DIYer, or just a, you know, anybody in this industry that wants to help somebody, May 31st is your chance to change somebody's life. Take advantage of it, and let's kind of hijack this World No Tobacco Day to help somebody in your life discover the pleasure of vaping, and hopefully you'll be able to extend their life. We'll be back again in 2 weeks.
Wait a second. Can you put the camera back on me here a little bit?
Boy, there you go. Please. So demanding. So demanding.
Any day now? What is up with this photo right here? What?
You don't like that?
No, you look skin and bones. You look like...
I'm not skin and bones. It's just the angle.
You look skin and bones in that photo. You got this 5-day beard going on. You look like a homeless guy who came off the street and they gave that T-shirt to.
I know. I'm sorry.
I don't like that photo. You're too skinny in that photo.
No, it's just the
What is it?
It's the angle, and because I'm stretching out the shirt, yeah. I look. How about this photo here? Do you like this photo here?
Which photo?
Isn't that sexy? Which one? I would.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. If I was into male Greeks, I would be all over that right there.
You never show the good photos of me. You always show the ones that make me look bad. But yeah. No, that's not true.
Every time there's a good photo, see, this goes back to where we started this whole
counseling.
Every time there is a good photo of Dimitri, I always say, "Hey, D," I said, "this is a really good photo of you." Or if I take a photo, I say, "Hey, Dimitri, this is a really good photo of you." You ever think he says anything ever nice? Anything?
I don't have to say I take good photos of you. I take great photos of you.
It could be like a really good photo of me. Well, what will he say? Look at those fucking Skechers. That's what he'll say.
Dan Donahue, can we have the telephone number to that counselor, buddy? I think it's time. I think it's time that we set up an appointment. Can she do Skype? Can we do it over Skype?
That would be such funny video.
All right. Don't forget, help your friends and family switch to vaping to extend their life. Have a wonderful evening, folks. We'll see you from Europe. Follow us on social media networks, or else we'll see you in 2 weeks right here on youtube.com/PBusardo. Have a wonderful evening.